Entrepreneurs Board of Investors is challenging America to pitch the next big idea during a 60-second elevator ride.
Time's up. This isn't a terrible idea.
You need 5 million product, I'd take care of that.
You don't make an investment based upon what you think you may do.
Let us decide if we think it's compelling enough.
If the pitch fails...
You choke so easily.
Oh, he's breaking the cardinal rule of pitching.
Unfortunately, send him down.
Going down.
No!
But if the pitch is successful...
We need this. Yeah. Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Boom, mother...
And it's not just up to the judges. Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch lets you, the viewer, get in on the action through crowdfunding.
You got a deal. Write that down.
Is the next billion-dollar idea on its way up? This is... Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
Going up.
Ready. Put him in the elevator.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, I'm J.D. Young from Wichita, Kansas, owner of Funky Monkey Shaved Ice. I've been in the business for 5 years. Within the last year, I opened up a shaved ice bar, in addition to my two other non-alcoholic shaved ice units. This last 7 months, I have done nearly $200,000 in sales out of my 400 square foot shaved ice bar. That's why I'm here today, and I want to expand to lower states where I can do it year-round. At $200,000 in sales, cost us about $60,000, so there's tons of profit and tons for us to share. I love the business. I love everything about it. This is what I do. This is what I do day in, day out, 16, 17 hours a day, and this is why I'm here, because I need to expand. I need more to do, and I need a business partnership.
So he has a bar that they serve
Five,
shaved ice
four,
as the drink?
Yeah. Three.
Okay. Just want to make sure I understood that.
One. Time's up.
What about a franchise?
A license?
A license or a franchise model? Worth hearing a little bit about it, because that's the first model I've ever heard that's tight enough to be a franchise business.
I agree.
And
yeah.
I'd love to discuss that with him.
Yeah, cool.
Me too.
I'd say bring him in.
He's a good guy. All right.
Open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
That's a great reaction.
How are you guys doing?
Hi.
Good.
Is it JD?
Yes.
All right,
there's a little cup.
Oh, I like the name.
There you go.
How are you?
Pretty good.
Thank you.
Ooh, there's some weight to that cup.
I see the 21 and over here. So that was one of our questions.
Yeah, fire away. Yes. This is your
topic.
Yeah,
I mean, so when you talk about the ice bar, the shaved ice bar, mm-hmm. is it literally a bar where you have alcohol in part of the ice, or is it just non-alcohol?
It's
different
in
flavors?
The ice. We do non-alcoholic and alcoholic. I sell a double shot of shaved ice alcohol for $10. It cost me no more than $2.
You have to be 21 to get in?
No.
Oh.
So you can bring your kids. So this is a really good opportunity. We're getting parents who come in, their kids can enjoy a non-alcoholic shaved ice. The adults can have one. It's family time.
And you have one location.
Yeah, we have one bar location. I have another, what I started out with 5 years ago, non-alcoholic. And then I have a mobile unit that I'm going to be getting my liquor license to do weddings and stuff like that.
That's what I was thinking. When
so
we
that's
talking
what
about
I'm
this,
doing.
I'm like, you need to drive to places.
And what are you looking for? So what's the ask?
So I'm looking for $200,000 for 20% of my business. And what that would be is to move into two other markets.
So how does $200,000 just break down the cost of actually opening a store?
Just the equipment-wise, I can walk in $5,000 to $10,000. You have your ice machine, your freezers, your flavors, and liquor. That's basically your bare bones, what you need.
But I would spend your money on a franchise or a licensed consultant, right? Because you have a perfect store in a box, and it's a proven business model, and it applies better to other areas than the one that you live in.
I don't know that it's worth $1 million today, but you know, $100,000 for 20%, which gets it started.
But yeah, I'm in for definitely for $100,000 for 20%. I'm in.
I don't want to be a party pooper here, but I think you're 6 months too early, even for us to make that investment. We can always circle back at a very short time.
We all have to agree on this show, so if not, we're allowed to contact you afterwards and work it out.
Yeah, I would say knock yourselves out.
And then I can do that I told you so dance all over Peter Goldberg. So.
All right. Well, thank you, guys.
Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah.
Thank
I'll
you.
Talk to you soon.
Thank
I
you,
love the concept.
Right? I'm speechless. I didn't think it was going to go this well. Got the doors to open and got contingent offer. So we'll see what happens here at a later date.
I'm highly disappointed in you. You're like you're the angel investor. You're supposed to inspire these. Like, you take no chance. What does that say up there?
Elevator pitch.
No, above it.
Entrepreneur.
Yeah, entrepreneur.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's an entrepreneur. We're investing in entrepreneurs.
It's a judgment call, and I'm going to put money where the person had the ability to implement on the idea at hand, and he wasn't there today.
Thank God you're not a race car driver. You'd never win.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, my name is Dimitri Boss, and I am the inventor entrepreneur behind this revolutionary and exciting new product that is patent issued called Genie Cone. Now, Genie Cone encompasses the entire spectrum of the market, from high-end fashion down to casual branding, licensing, and what I'm going to show you today, which is this arts and crafts kit that allows young girls the opportunity to design their own customized ponytail holder. You simply take this base cone, put it in your hair, which creates the ponytail, and the kit comes with five blank interchangeable covers that simply slide on and off of the base cone once you've colored them with the three bottles of glitter glue or the stickers that we provide. We also give you a template that allows you the opportunity to trace out your own personalized designs. And we're working on a new LED version, which is really exciting. I'm seeking $70,000 in exchange for 5% of the royalty streams based on the licensing deals and the distribution channels that you folks can bring to the table. So five, the genie says, four, please, three, open sesame.
Two,
thank you for your consideration.
Time's up.
I can't help with the licensing deal.
No. I mean,
that's what he's asking.
Customization is definitely a trend, but...
But he's asking specifically for us to license.
There's no brand behind this. This has to be branded. It has to be done by one of the major brands, or there has to be a major influencer behind it. I mean, otherwise it's going to be a novelty in a low-end toy store for a season, and then it's going to get knocked off and be over.
He's closed all the toy stores.
Yeah, exactly. I don't see this one. This is Arts and Crafts Hour.
Yeah, we're here to help entrepreneurs, you know, succeed, but we're also here to look for a $1 billion business. I just don't see it here.
Unfortunately, send him down.
Going down.
Oh, okay. That's what it is. Mm-hmm. It didn't seem like I had enough of interest with the judges so that they would bring me on in, and they sent me back down. So, we move on to another day.
Ready to hear the next pitch.
Me too.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
Hi, I'm Elisa, the founder of Hero, a backpack line at the intersection of media and retail. I launched Hero in 2016 in response to the divisive rhetoric on the rise. Each backpack carries an inclusive and empowering heroic story and supports human rights initiatives that stand up for equality. As a Russian immigrant, I was bullied growing up for not speaking English. And so the idea for Hero is if you're that kid on the playground that feels like you don't have a voice, you see someone wearing a Hero, you know they'll have your back. I'm here today, fresh off the Forbes 30 Under 30 list, seeking $500,000 for 5% equity so I can build a team, invest in marketing, and together with you, create the next generation of world-changing heroes.
Five, four, three, two,
I guess I have more time, but thank you.
I think she did a fantastic job.
That
was probably one of the best pitches we've seen.
Yeah. I mean, this could spread like wildfire in schools.
She's on the 40, 30 under 30. She's getting publicity and probably traction.
That's a hell of a valuation for a backpack.
Obviously, this is just a message, really, right? I mean, this is a message, not a backpack.
I know she didn't talk about revenue, but I'd like to hear more. Let's do it.
Okay.
Okay. Right. We need this.
We need
this. Okay, open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
Hello.
Hi. Hi. I brought gifts.
Oh, really? I get it.
Yeah, these are for all of you. And you guys can all mix and match.
And stars. I love the stars.
Burgundy.
Burgundy.
We're matching.
Okay.
So if you'll all pick up your backpacks and open the front compartment and see what you find.
Nice.
Got this.
I like it.
I just wanted to give kids something that would inspire them.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought, well, everyone uses a backpack. Why not put inspiring heroic stories?
When did you decide to do this?
It was actually a college business plan. And so I just wanted to create something to inspire and empower anyone who might feel like they don't have a voice to speak up and stand up for themselves.
So There must be revenue tied to this already with the valuation you have.
My current revenue is $35,000. And that's what I've been able to do on a bootstrap budget.
That's annualized?
That's over the last 1.5 years.
Okay, so 35 in total.
Yeah, 35 in total. But again, no investment from
my
end.
Selling online, like on a website, or is this in stores? Where is the distribution?
Currently just online.
How much do these sell for? And ultimately, what is your cost?
So that one I sell direct to consumer for $99, and it costs me about $22 to make after landed costs. So I have a pretty good profit margin selling direct to consumer.
Do you feel $99 is a little expensive? I mean, it seems like when I've looked at this stuff, it's more like $29.99, $39.49. It just seems like, especially if it's the younger person that, you know, they don't have as much disposable income.
When I launched, I was laser focused on parents buying for their kids, but it's been Gen Z buying. They just really have empathized with my brand values.
So you said earlier that what you projected you could do in the next year is really what justifies this valuation.
Yes, that's
so
correct.
So what does that look like? How much revenue do you think you can do with a $500,000 investment?
$1 million.
New $1 million, okay.
Unfortunately, you don't make an investment based upon what you think you may do. It's based upon what you are doing, because that may happen or it may not happen. Essentially, we would just be making an investment in you.
I love it. You said you sell through your website right now, direct to consumer. So on behalf of GoDaddy, who is the leader of building websites and building your online presence, we'd like to offer you $10,000 to further that, as well as two different options of packages to help with the website to take it to the next level. One, of course, can be done yourself, and the others with an expert from GoDaddy who can help you do that, just to build your online presence and help that grow and give you just a little bit more to take something another step further. And maybe it's just going to pay for a legal fee, but look, it's a step in the right direction.
Absolutely.
I think that that is an amazing offer. I mean, that's $10,000 more than you came here with.
Yeah.
And I think we would all like to follow this really closely.
If it goes the way we all think it is going to go, you're going to be successful.
Well, thank you all. This
thank
is great.
You
yeah, I really appreciate
yeah, very
it.
Very impressive.
Thank you, Heroes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I thought that was great. I mean, they love my product, and what more can I ask for? I learned that my product resonates with more than just Gen Z. It resonated with each and every single one of them on a very authentic and human level.
Your 60 seconds begins now. Going up.
I'm Jerry Bessa, CEO of iPowerUp. I have 20 years experience in the portable power industry. Today I've patented a product that I'm bringing to market, which is a solar iPhone charging case that is the highest performance available in the marketplace. It will charge an iPhone in roughly 3.6 hours from zero to full, and basically will save you in any emergency communication that's needed. My current sales in the marketplace are basically $860,000, and I have a 40% margin. I'm seeking $300,000 for either an equity or convertible debt investment. And I'm looking forward to being able to provide a unique power to the world marketplace, since there's 2.6 billion users in the market today. Everyone can have a capability, much like this product will show us. You always have power for whenever you need to communicate.
One. Time's up.
The only question I have is, like, my phone sits out in the sun, it shuts down because it's hot.
That's a good question.
My problem is, if you're in the accessory business, one, you don't know the technology that's coming. Two, you have to constantly be competing against yourself.
This is a big business.
Yeah.
And if he does have a mousetrap that ultimately works, this could be massive.
I'd listen to more.
I'd listen to more, just because I think the upside could be massive here.
Okay, open the doors.
Welcome to the boardroom.
All right.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Thank
Welcome.
You for seeing me. Today I'm going to show you the highest performance solar product for the iPhone charging cases. This works for the iPhone 6, 6S, 7, and 8.
Is your trademark in the actual full design as it is, or is, like, could you separate the solar panels as a separate component with an attachment so it doesn't have to be a case?
In this particular case, it's fixed, so you don't remove it. But the idea is that if you have it on your phone, you're actually emergency prepared.
So your phone has to be plugged into the charger with the panels open.
No, you can take the phone out because this operates independent of the phone.
So
the ideal scenario is use your phone at will. When you're low, if you have no traditional, take it out, set it in the sun. And because you have the meter, you can literally set the incidence angle of light to get the optimum charging.
Okay.
The 300,000, that'll get how much product into market?
It's not about me using this capital to buy product. I'm using the factoring firm and I don't have a limit.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, which is very smart.
Thank you.
Yeah.
What do you mean you don't have a limit?
Okay, let's put it this way. I have a benchmark. He will take on any big box or any major account that has, you know, AAA rated credit.
So much of a case is the feel in your hand, in your pocket. Can I at least see it?
Of course. This particular model was designed for...
It's pretty heavy. This is for the iPhone 8?
Correct. iPhone 6, 6S, 7, and 8. As far as I know, we have one of the thinnest designs in the market.
Yep. What do you do full-time?
This.
Okay.
The thing that is troubling me the most is I didn't like the feel of it, and it was heavy.
If you prefer a lighter model, hold that one.
Well, I mean, this is still big.
Okay, that's a big phone.
But that's a bigger phone.
I understand.
I'm form-fitted to the size of the phone.
I understand.
I'm struggling most with your demeanor, to be honest.
Sorry.
That's where I struggle the most. I think all this makes sense, but you seem so cocky, and I'm like trying to get through this. Like, your concept makes sense, but you as a person, it's getting hard to
want to
believe in you. I'm just being really honest from a vibe standpoint, and
all right.
I don't know if that's affected any of your deals, but I'm sitting here like, I don't know, just be humble.
I'm out. The energy doesn't seem right.
Okay.
So
I guess we'll see what happens.
Yeah, yes. Prove us wrong.
Sorry you felt that way.
I've always been known for being honest.
The woman didn't care much for my demeanor. I think that sort of started the flow from a positive to a negative. I don't get where she's coming from, but maybe she's at the end of the day and she's tired. I don't know. I think they missed the mark on this one.
Wow. Danica, I have to say, I don't know if the word is proud or I have admiration.
I think
you said what we were all thinking.
Appreciate it.
To support any of these entrepreneurs through crowdfunding, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. Coming up on the next Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch.
It's not about the man, it's about the product.
We're going to be savvy investors and not emotional investors.
That's right.
I feel like Rocky.
To apply for season 3, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch.